Chocolate Al, good to see you, man.
Hey, good to see you, man. How you doing?
Good. How the hell you doing?
I'm doing great, you know, living the dream.
I was doing a breakdown of a movie, and I'm like, is that Chocolate Al? And you look, and it's Chocolate Al, but you're the coach. What is this?
Yeah, well, you know, honestly, they sent me the film, the script, and I'm like, oh, you know, oh, I actually like this. This looks like for a, because I've seen a lot of fight movies sent to me, and I'm like, oh, it's kind of, I don't. But they brought it to me, and I really liked it. But I'm like, you know what? And I'm all, when they shooting, and they're shooting 10 days. I had two surgeries 10 days apart, and they were shooting like 10 days after that. So I'm like, I'm not gonna do it. But I saw a couple glaring little errors in there, like, not for most people wouldn't know the difference, but like, you know, like we're little fight
players.
Like someone, you know, it's about weight cut and certain things where I was like, oh man, it's not, that doesn't happen. That's not,
that's not right.
So, but I'm like, you know what? I like the movie enough. I'm going to call this guy. I want to talk to him about, so we can at least make the changes so we can, you know, maybe if it gets made, it'll look good. And he goes, oh, and I told him why I can't do it because of this, but he's like, well, you know what? I wanted you to be the coach, actually. I'm like, not the fighter. I'm like, oh, coach. I can pull the coach out. I don't have to do any fight scenes in that. So it worked out. So we worked out a deal, and I was there.
Do you have the patience to coach guys in real life?
I actually do. I like coaching guys that are getting ready for fights. Like once you get to the level, I used to have a gym, and I don't mind teaching classes. And I always, my thing, the teacher's, it's job to be enthusiastic and get the energy in the class. But I prefer really, I really prefer working with guys that are, you know, at that next level ready to fight. You know, because it's fun to watch a fight and know you showed some guy something different that he's doing now, and it works for him. And I, you know, I don't care what they say, but if I, me seeing the music makes me happy, you know? Mm. So, so as a coach, but I'm a different coach. And I can try to kind of play more of like John Hackman, more of a calm corner guy, calm, you know, demeanor with that stuff. Because I'm more like, actually, when I'm in the corner, I'm the opposite of when I fight. Like I'm the guy that's screaming at you if you're not doing it. I threaten to hit the guy. Hey, if you do that one more time, don't come back to the corner. I'll hit you in the chair. You know? So I say to my guys,
has that worked?
It's worked. They didn't. I told one guy because you know he was winning around and I was telling him he was winning around striking. Then he shot, got taken down, and lost a round. Second round is the same thing. And I'm like, he won the round, but you know if you get taken down for the last minute of the round, you might lose the round. And especially in smaller shows, I'm like, if you do that one more time, do not come back to this corner. I'm going to put you in the chair. I told you not to shoot this guy. But
do you remember?
But he won the fight. He went out. He didn't shoot again. So it was good.
It worked. It worked. Yeah. Your guy Glover was cornered by your coach last night. What'd you think of his fight?
Oh man, Glover did amazing. It's great to see. I love watching him fight. Still, he's always had that condition. Always tough, man. He just, you know, he'll go. He's a goer.
Yeah. Speaking of coaching, people, and obviously most people have never fought and never will, but people were critical of Anthony Smith's coaches that maybe they should have stopped the fight because Glover was really, really, really messing him up physically. What are your thoughts on that?
I don't know. It's their decision. I think not enough coaches are willing to do that. You know, like because I said something about the Tony fight. I didn't like that the referee stopped Tony. Now, as a friend, I was glad it was stopped. Mm-hmm. But I think that should have left to his corner and him. But mm-hmm. He's too tough for his own good, and I know people like that. But he's not. But he's one of those guys that, you know, I think it would have felt a lot better for me. Like if you're gonna do that to me, if my coach does it, it's one thing. He says you're done. John's been with me forever. I know. He's the why he's doing it. You know, it's mm-hmm. So, you know, I sometimes I don't like that. I don't like that a ref, because that was probably the best, because I don't think Tony was going to do anything. Don't get too mad at me. I said that. I'm like, I'm not. I just know Tony. I knew, and I really, my knee-jerk reaction was I knew Tony was going to be upset.
Yeah.
So I know how I would feel.
Yeah.
And I was feeling bad for Tony. Like, why? Mm-hmm. Why'd you do that to him? Like, his coach did it. You know, it's a lot easier to take. You know, like, you're done. You know, you can.
Yeah.
But you know, it is what it is.
It is what it is.
Yeah, I always said, you know, I always wanted the extra chance. But I mean, sometimes some guys, if you're not there, like if you're not responding correctly, if you're not, you know, it's hard to get. Or some maybe it's a little. Maybe you should. You know, mm-hmm. I've seen ones where you tell guys, hey man, if you don't show something, and I told a guy, man, he's taking a beating. One of my guys told me he's taking a beating. The whole first round, you know, just sitting there exchanging with a guy, but getting destroyed. I said, look, man, if you take him down, you can beat him. But if you don't take a legitimate shot in the first 2 minutes of this next round, I'm throwing in the towel. He didn't shoot, I threw in the towel. I'm not going to watch you stand there. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not going to take punches in the face. You're not going to win the fight that way. I've trained with that guy. You know, it's one of those things. It's just, you know, that's the sort of coach should do, but not all the time. It's not all the time.
Man, you got a lot of experience and thoughts and instincts on that. So when they asked you to play a coach in this movie, that made sense right away. Besides your injury, it made sense right away.
Yeah. I like, and it's fun for me to try to play a different coach too. Like, I try to play somebody else. Cause if I'm trying to play me as a coach, then it's hard to get, do it that way. It's hard to beat because there's not a real fight going on, but you know, when I'm trying to play a character, it's different. It makes it easier to kind of get into playing different things. Now, I wasn't as quirky as John. I wasn't as crazy as John. If you know John, John's a little nuts. But he's funny.
Yes.
I'm not sure they would like some of my humor if playing John.
This movie is set in the idea that a pro wrestler goes in and is fighting for real. When mainstream media is asking you about this, what are their questions about this?
You know, people are like, oh, can they do that? Is it possible? I mean, obviously, I mean, it's been done. You know, Brock Lesnar did it. But also you have guys like CM Punk came in. Like, and people ask, I've been asked a lot, like, as fighters, if we accept them coming over, if it bothers us that they come over. Like, for me, like, I don't mind bringing other eyes to the sport or more people, more fans to the sport. If you can't fight, you're not going to be around long anyway. But if you can fight, we're pretty accepting of guys that can fight. I don't care where you came from. If you come over and you can fight, cool. You know, I'm cool with that. But if you come over, I really didn't like them feeding CM Punk. I mean, not necessarily the first guy was fine, but the second guy, I mean, what was he, 1-4 or something? Like, I don't know, that guy didn't belong in the UFC either.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no reason, man. So to have him fighting someone on the UFC, for me, from the UFC level, that shouldn't even be there. I mean, I think if you're going to cross over and you want to fight at a UFC level, at the minimum, you need to have at least one of the guys that are kind of like that journeyman, UFC journeyman guy that is right at the bottom rung, you know, where they're kind of the guy that if you can beat him, you can go, you move on. If you can't beat him, you go back to the minors, basically. You know what I mean? I mean, at the bare minimum, I think they should have them fight if they're going to bring someone out.
So John Moxley plays the pro wrestler that becomes a fighter. What did you think of him right away? Did you buy it that this guy could fight when you met him and you saw him?
Well, yeah. I mean, he's got a great personality and he does a great job selling the stuff. He's a good dude. So I like watching it. He did all the stuff for the PR stuff for that stuff was great. It was fun.
Didn't you just want to maybe just punch him in the face just a little, just to see if he could take it?
No, that actually never crossed my mind. I was actually happy he was there and he was doing a great job.
Yeah. You and I chatted for a second and you said he had a funny story from.
Oh yeah. You were asking a funny story. There's a lot of stuff out there. You know, I was on the way there and some girl sitting next to me was going, hey, where are you going? Where are you out to? I'm like, yeah, I'm out to Regina. And she goes, oh, no, babe. It's unfortunately, it's Regina.
It's Saskatchewan. Like,
oh, yeah. I'm all, okay, okay. And I mean, a few jokes they say there, but one of the funny things. So me and Luke Rockwell will decide we're gonna go eat at a different new place. It's supposed to be walking. This is a hotel, and we're on our phone, but we're talking. We walk by it. We're like 2 blocks by it, and it was negative 25 Celsius. A little colder than that night. Like,
yeah,
we're walking with the wind at our back, and it wasn't so bad. You know, it really wasn't. We walked past the place about 2 blocks, and then we had to turn around and come back into the wind. Man, I thought my face was gonna fall off. I mean, we walked 2 blocks a day. Cold doesn't bother me. I like the cold, but I mean, and while we're there, I was like, oh man, you're lucky you came here at a warm spell at this time of the year. I'm like, what?
Yeah, man.
I don't think I want to be here when it gets any colder. Like, it's like, it's just cold.
That central Canada cold is a whole different level.
Yeah, but, I like cold. I got no problem with it with the cold weather. I mean, I'm known for not getting cold from stuff, but it's like, man, that's a different cold.
That's real. The little tip to remember how to say Regina, they say it's the town that rhymes with fun.
I didn't realize, the movie, there's a, I can't think of the movie now.
The Witch.
It had Regina in it.
I don't remember either. We should remember it because it's like one movie in the whole world that has Regina in it.
Deadpool.
Deadpool.
He talks about it in one of the things. I'm like, hey, I know that place.
That's right.
But I've seen the movie like 3 or 4 times, and I'm like, I never even noticed that he say anything about it.
Man.
Not till you've been there, I guess.
Yeah,
it's true. People were great, and I had a great time there, though. It was a really hospitable place.
I'm from that area of Canada, man. Those are some good people out there. It's true.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Now, last thing, just what do you want people to know about this movie? I hope people get to see it.
I mean, it's a good story. It moves along well, and I think they'll like it. So give it a shot, man. It's a fun watch.
Chuck, man, it is really, really good to see you. Thanks for doing this.
Thanks, man. Thanks for having me.
New legend!